And welcome back to the Patriot Sports Network for Patriot women's soccer action on Hartzler Field in Florence, South Carolina. I'm Alex Wober, the voice in the booth, bringing you Patriot soccer on this Wednesday evening. Before we get into the action, first, let's check out our pregame interview with Patriots heads women's soccer coach, Chelsea Parker. All right, we're here with head women's soccer coach, Chelsea Parker. Just talk about your overall thoughts on the season so far.
Yeah, I think it's been a good season for us. I think we're a different team than we were last year. With that being said, some teams have come out and gotten better as well. It's kind of been all over the board with some of the results that we've been seeing. But, it's been a good season for us so far.
Talk about, you know, a little bit of adversity this season coming into this match against Mount Olive. What is the mentality going into it?
The mentality is just to get to 3 points, knowing that at the end of the day, whatever happens, we just need to get in the tournament, and that's kind of what our focus is. We're going through a little bit of adversity with some injuries, but other than that, you know, what the difference from last year is we've got depth on the bench this year and players that can step up and fully handle the job, whereas I don't think we had that last year.
And speaking of, you know, a lot of depth on this team, talk about, you know, a lot of new faces, a lot of fresh people coming in, freshmen from all over the place. So just talk about the recruiting class this year and how well they've performed.
Yeah, I think a lot of freshmen have come in and stepped in. The Brosnahan twins are a good example. Prior to Emma's injury, she was a big player for us that stepped up. Abby Brosnahan has stepped up big time. Johanna from Sweden has been a big one for us and has kind of become a staple for us on the wing side. And today, Emily Casey will be a big one for us, getting her debut in the goal.
Absolutely. Well, you can check out this game right after this interview, and we're excited. So good luck tonight, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Welcome back here to the Patriot Sports Network. Today we have the University of Mount Olive Trojans coming into the Swamp to face the home defending Francis Marion University Patriots. The Patriots men's soccer team will follow the women's game at 7 p.m. here in a Conference Carolina's doubleheader. Patriots women's program enters this season for its second year in Conference Carolinas. Altogether, 13 players return from last year's squad. Parker also brought in a recruiting class of 11 newcomers that includes 8 freshmen and 3 transfers.
And your Francis Marion University Patriots.
As we are set to begin action here in this Conference Carolinas matchup, let's take a look at both sides, starting with the University of Mount Olive Trojans. Let's take a look at their starting lineup here. Starting in goal for the Trojans, number 1, Nicole Solicito. At forward, number 3, Delia Allwood. Number 5, defender Jocelyn Gott. Number 6, forward / midfielder Malwyn Gaffis. Midfielder, number 9, Olivia Womack. Number 10, midfielder Amanda McLeod. Number 11, defender Sarah Brechlin. Number 14, defender Scarlett Espinosa. Number 16, defender Samantha Hamrick. Number 21, midfielder Ashley Lindsay. And number 31, forward Tiana Hill. That wraps up the Trojan side. Let's take a look at your Francis Marion University Patriots in goal. Starting over the injured Michaela Willits, number 0, Emily Casey. At forward / midfielder, number 3, Lalandra Jarvis. Midfielder, number 6, Anara Ezagire. Forward / midfielder, number 8, Jada Pearson. Forward, number 9, Valentina Restrepo. Midfielder, number 14, Haley Sink. Defender, number 15, Gracie Adkins. Number 17, defender Courtney Deneau. Number 18, midfielder / defender, Abby Brosnahan. Number 19, defender, Joanna Kitholm. And number 21, back in the defense as well, Paula Santabria. Your Patriots are coached by head coach Chelsea Parker and assisted by Maximiliano Rocco. And Daly McEwen, the athletic trainer for the Patriots, is Haley Black.
Number 1, a senior from Stony Point, New York, Nicole Solicito. Number 3, a sophomore from Piscataway, New Jersey, Dalia Allwood. Number five,
as we take a look back at last year's venture versus the University of Mount Olive under head coach Chelsea Parker. The first time these two teams met was October 19th of last year at Mount Olive, North Carolina, and the Patriots were dropped with a final score of 1-8. The Trojans come into this match against the Patriots sitting at number 4 in the conference so far through matches of September 20th. Mount Olive sits right now with 6 conference points, 2-0 in conference play, averaging 3 conference Carolinas points per game. They are 4-3 overall with a .571 winning percentage, have forced 17 goals and allowed 10 so far. The Patriots sitting closer to the middle right now with 1 conference point, a conference record of 0 wins, 2 losses and 1, excuse me, 2 ties, 1 losses, 2 losses, 1 tie, excuse me. A 30.33 conference points per game average, and an overall record of 1-4-2, a .286 winning percentage, and have forced 3 goals to find the back of the net, allowing 11 so far in the season. And like we said, looking at the starting lineups, starting in goal for the Patriots will be number 0, Emily Casey, the freshman out of Charlotte, North Carolina. She'll get her first start, her debut, as a Patriot here against a pretty tough Mount Olive squad. So we'll see how both sides come out here in the first half, and we'll see how the freshman does guarding the net for the Patriots. Looking at the Trojans lineup, not many freshmen starting for this team. A total of 1
number 19, a freshman
starting for this Trojan squad. A lot of seniors
and 21, a junior
across this lineup, as we can see, and a mixture of sophomores in there as well. The Trojans are coached by Ian Brophy, assisted by Ebony Campbell and Sydney Griner. Our officials today in the first match of the doubleheader, Thomas Rutherford, and he's assisted by Wayne Pavlicek and Mark DeBlois. So the Patriots really need a point here to jump up in conference standings. A big win here from today could put them up a few spots in those conference standings and could also turn some heads around the conference as well. We talked with head coach Chelsea Parker earlier this week and today about the match versus Mount Olive, and she basically said that they have to find a way to set themselves up better. And I think when you're in any sport, when you're any coach, and you haven't had the most perfect start to the season, that is something that you have to focus on, is just setting yourself up for success. You know, all the goals, the assists, the nice plays, everything like that's going to come naturally, but setting yourself up for those things, that's going to be a key piece for the Patriots today. Remember, our men's soccer program will follow up after this game at 7 o'clock versus the Trojans as well. May see both sides getting some water breaks throughout the match, as it is a hot one today in Florence, South Carolina. Fall is about to start here in the southern region of the United States, but still very hot for any team to be performing in these conditions. So we may see our official Thomas Rutherford take one break, two breaks, maybe each half. We'll see. both sides in their general huddle up before play starts here between two conference opponents who are looking to change the hierarchy of power here in Conference Carolinas. Up top for your Patriots so far, we're seeing number 8, Jada Pearson, Valentina Restrepo, Lalandra Jarvis, and Haley Sink with sort of a winger role for Shawana Kithpalm, who plays more of a wingback position. But I'm sure she'll be heavily involved in the counterattacks and any attacks in general for the Patriots. She's got speed and probably the most physical player, Good battle between her and J.G. Guerin between physicality. And we have kicked off with the Trojans holding possession first. Something Chelsea Parker talked about earlier in the season was their pace and their ability to get to the ball a lot faster than they were last year. And we have seen that so far. They've made it quite difficult on opponents to move the ball, to put the ball in the back of the net. And they've also made it really hard in terms of keeping the opponents on their toes. Today, the Trojans are going to have a lot of trouble, I think, dealing with the Patriots' pace, their freshness up top as Jarvis sends a ball into the box, which is deflected out of bounds. And gives the Patriots their first corner kick of the game. The first corner kick of the game going towards the Patriots. And the seems to be the all-time corner kick taker for the Patriots. Courtney Deneau, the defender out of Greenville, South Carolina, going to take this one. She's going to whip that one into the box a little short, and that one going to be headed back towards Deneau, who comes back onside, sends another ball into the box, over the head of the keeper, into the back of the net! Patriots have jumped out first in the first 2 minutes, not even 2 minutes through. Let's take a look at that replay real quick as the second chance from Deneau comes in off the head of a Patriot and just over the head of the keeper, Solicito for the Trojans. What a surprise here as the Patriots quickly get on board. They lead 1-0. That was an Abby Brosnahan finish. Wonderful stuff by the Patriots. Jumping out early against the Trojans. Their fourth goal of the season. Just like we talked about in the pregame, they set themselves up early. And they finished when they had a chance. Casey going to come up and scoop this one up. Santa Bria defending. That's Allwood getting by. Shot inside the box. Good defense that time by Deneau. Gives the Patriots a throw in here near the corner flag. Santa Bria boots it out of Patriot territory, and that one responded quickly that time. Number 10, Amanda McLeod with it. Top of the box, they'll get a free kick there from some physical play, that time coming from Brosnahan, who scored the first goal for the Patriots. Abby Brosnahan's first career goal as a Patriot as well. So a free kick, not really just outside the box, but just a couple yards back. Definitely a shot opportunity for the Trojans, as keeper today for the Patriots, Emily Casey, substituting in for the injured Michaela Willits. And they will not take a shot. They'll play it into the box. Not sure where they were going with that plan, but it was quickly broken up by the Patriots. Ball into the box once again. That's number 9 for the Trojans, Olivia Womack. Defended well by the Patriots. It'll be a throw-in going their way. Patriots are just trying to get it out of their territory, move it down the field. And Trojans playing with a sense of urgency as the Patriots got on the board very quickly. Ball in the box. Casey comes out for it and brings it in beautifully for the Patriots. Punts it to about midfield to Restrepo. Double teamed now by Brosnahan and Restrepo. Gets to Adkins, has to play it back to Casey. Plays Adkins back. And Adkins just gets it forward away from the back line of the Patriots. Casey just going to have an easy pickup there. She's had a lot of time to watch the Patriots and kind of be a practice player so far as a freshman for FMU, but she's getting a chance today. She's seen a lot of the field. She's had time in practice to really get to know her teammates better. As like we said, she is coming in as a freshman, so a lot of returnees back on the squad that she's playing with from last year's team. Simpalm on the pressure that time. They're going to play it back to their keeper, Solicito. Over the top ball, outrun. One-on-one gets by Casey, and that is Jocelyn Gott, who quickly draws things back up for the Trojans. We're at 1-1 here. We've had two goals in the first about 7 minutes. Let's check out the replay that time as we see Gott get around Casey with the almost pass to herself, and then has a wide-open net for the Trojans. 1-1 now. Here with about 38 and a half to go. Free kick for the Patriots coming up just a couple yards past midfield. Defender Gracie Adkins is going to take this one. Chip pass into the net. It was going to Brosnahan, but a Trojan ended up breaking it up. To be one, Deneau with the deflection. Stays in bounds. Off of a Trojan is going to be a Patriot throw in here just about midfield. A It's actually a free kick, not a throw-in for FMU. They called a foul. And Adkins' ball that time is scissor kicked back towards midfield. Streppo with the pressure as well as Pearson. Patriots are trying to make the Trojans to make quick decisions, which is a good strategy for what the Patriots are, a very quick and pacey team. In terms of looking at last year's squad, putting pressure on the Trojans and making them act quickly isn't a bad idea. Just got to be consistent with it. Don't let up on it. You know, if you some of your players are allowing some of the Trojans to make easy passes or aren't being pressured heavily enough, maybe that's when you make a substitution, get some fresh legs out there. So far, good stuff by FMU. Throw in front of the Patriots bench. Streppo tries to split some Trojans. That one has to be pushed out wide, and it's going to be a Patriot throw in. Danu has to make a quick decision. She's got to play it to Restrepo. Ball was going to find the boots of Pearson, but stepped in front of that time by Hamrick. Free kick now for FMU. Adkins going to take it. Ball into the box. Restrepo gets ahead on it. So does Ezeguirre. Turn around. Broken up by the Trojans. Shot from Pearson. And just over the net. Free kick now for the Trojans. Very back and forth physical plays from both sides. Three fouls for each side so far. Ball into the box. Santa Bria able to get ahead on it, and Adkins tops it forward, and Restrepo tries to play sink, but she is shadowed by Espinosa. Danu breaks up the through ball, handball though, so a free kick here for UMO. Ball played to the far side. Pearson gets it back to the Trojans' back line. Finds the boots of Restrepo. She's got pace. Outside the foot pass to Jarvis. And no foul. Continue play here. Jarvis went down. And Jarvis did not get the call for the free kick just outside the box. Might have been a trip up between her and a Trojan. Danu right there for the split. Danu again on the deflection. Rutherford will have a word with Restrepo on the play that time. Ball into the box, far side. Headed out, finds Pearson. Pearson dangerously goes back into the Patriots box, but finds Simple. Throw in here for Mount Olive on the Patriots' side of the field. And we'll get a substitution as Kylie Reif comes in for the Patriots. Pearson comes out. Pavoni comes in. And Sink comes off. Bavoni was on the way to intercept. Ball played to her. But number five, Jocelyn Gott, who scored the first goal for the Trojans, is there. They actually ended up giving the goal to, that is correct, actually. Dalia Alwood had the lone goal for the Trojans. Reif takes a hard fall that time. Comes up walking a bit awkward. Might have taken the breath out of her for a second. free kick going to be taken by Garon. Ball into the box over the head of Santa Bria. Shot from Brosnahan finds its way into the hands of Solicito. Garon breaks up the pass. Stays with it. Reif tries to get a boot on it. Streppo dodging and diving. Fake pass. Back to Brosnahan. And Reif made an effort for it. But Solicito able to get it first. This time, Jocelyn Gott cuts inside, plays a Trojan, finds its way back to Womack. She takes a shot. Casey that time there to put it down. Cut off by Garon. Played to Reif, but it was behind her. Free kick now for the Trojans. Just under 25 to go here in the first half. Score still remains 1-1. Off the head of Adkins. Ball into the box. Batted out by Sipbaum. Shot just left. Goal kick here for Casey. Francis Marion University Athletics would like to thank the following sponsors: Adidas, Circle Park Behavioral Health Services, McLeod Regional Medical Center, Ken Jackson and Remax Professionals, Pepsi, McDonald's, Rains Hospitality, including Fairfield Inn, Spring Hill Suites, Courtyard by Marriott, Comfort Inn, and Hyatt Place, King Cadillac Buick GMC, McLeod Sports Medicine, Chick-fil-A, State Farm and Agent Jim Stewart, Quincy Steakhouse, Little Caesars, La Quinta Inn and Suites, KFC and Arby's, Florence Toyota, Waffle House, PD Electric Cooperative, Sparrow and Kennedy's Tractor Supply, McCall Supply Incorporated, Western Sizzlin' Steakhouse, State Credit Union, and Zaxby's. Free kick here given to the Trojans. Free kick this time, chipped into the box at the penalty marker. Up in the air now. And they'll give a free kick for FMU with some batting around that time between both sides. Cut off that time by Espinosa. Cut off by Garon and Brosnahan forces McLeod back. Free kick now for the Trojans. And that time, they knock over Casey as she's going up for the catch. No card, but a foul given towards the Trojans. It'll be a free kick for the Patriots. Brosnahan with the touch. Turns back, plays Deneau. Chip pass for Pavoni. Too much on it this time. Goal kick for the Trojans with about 20 to go. So they will take a water break now. Both sides will get a quick break. 19:50 on the clock. We'll take a quick break. Come right back here on the Patriot Sports Network.
Conference Carolinas is where tradition is unmatched and excellence is earned daily in the classroom, during practice, and in high-level competition.
Tigerville has become Title Town. Our virtues set us apart. We daily work to build champions in body, mind, and soul. It's who we are. This is Conference Carolinas.
Decked out in their regalia, and as you look up at all those people, you see families, huge families. And you know why all those people are there? Because this is the very first one, the very first graduate. So special.
All right, back here on the Patriot Sports Network, we've got a goal kick this time for Solicito. As we said earlier in the broadcast, it is a hot day, so both sides get a quick break that time, get a little bit of H2O in their system. Patriots have done a good job so far of containing the Trojans after their first goal. Same can be said about the Trojans' defense. Done a good job of holding the Patriots' attempts and shot creations down, as will be a Patriot throw-in now. Ball played that time, finds the feet, but just hopped underneath Jocelyn Gott. Headed out of bounds that time by number 14, Scarlett Espinosa. Cut off by Espinosa. Stays with the Trojans. Nobody there for the Patriots as Jarvis's run started late. Free kick now for the Trojans. That's Copley. Flip pass, try to get over the head of Adkins. Now you have Delia Alwood. Penalty kick now for the Trojans. Delia Alwood will get a chance to put her second goal in the back of the net. This will be a huge test for freshman keeper Emily Casey. Allwood, a sophomore forward out of Piscataway, New Jersey. And it will be taken by Malwin Gafas, and she puts it in the back of the net for the Trojans. University of Mount Olive take a 2-1 lead that time. Take a quick replay and check out the kick that time, and goes right up the middle. Against Casey. Casey was expecting her to go left or right. Patriots down 2-1 now with 17 to go in the first half. substitutions for both sides as Lindsay Downey comes on for Valentina Restrepo, and number 7, Emily Hine, comes on for the Trojans. Comes on for Tiana Hill. Santa Bria defends and gets in front, taken away by Gott in the box. Off the top post, that was Delia Allwood that time. My apologies for the confusion on the field. The numbers for Mount Olive, 3 and 5, are throwing me off just a tad bit, but that time was Allwood, who has one goal already in the match and drew the penalty kick for the Trojans to put their second goal in, coming from Gaffeis. Put into new in a spin cycle. Ball played in towards the back of the box. Going to find Copley. She's going to try and get around Jarvis. Prisnan tries to remove it out of the box. Handball this time off the Trojans will be a Patriot free kick. The 2022-23 Conference Carolinas Championship season is coming soon. Please visit conferencecarolinas.com/championships to learn more about all the 2022-23 Conference Carolinas Championships. Santa Bria right there gets it to Pavoni. Conference Carolinas is committed to aligning with businesses that share our common values and, like us, strive to attain excellence and virtue in all endeavors. We work hard to make our corporate partnerships a truly beneficial relationship through mutually agreed-upon customization that will lead to unparalleled exposure. Conference Carolinas would like to thank our corporate partners, Barnes & Noble College, Bufkin & Baker, Cambria Hotel Greenville, Championship Award Guys, Digital Scoreboards by Formetco, Herf Jones, Hometown Ticketing, Hourathon, Huddle, Marriott Spartanburg, McGriff Insurance Services, McMillan Paz and Smith, Plus Incorporated, Score Shots, SCS by Floor Action, Sidearm Sports, Southern Recognition LLC, South State Bank, Ticket Smarter, Toledo Ticket Technologies, and Vernon Graphics and Promotions, Vazi, and We Played Sports. Please visit conferencecarolinas.com to learn more about Conference Carolinas corporate partners. Just under 13 to go here in the first half. Trojans lead 2-1. Garon draws the foul for FMU. Free kick now for the Patriots. Played into the box, finds the foot of Reif, just left for the Patriots. Goal kick now for Solicito, and two subs coming in now for the Trojans. Comes off the foot of Casey, a bit weird. That time almost found its way back to the Trojans. Here's Jarvis with it. She gets cut off by Trojan defender. Gives him a throw in here in front of the bench. Sitbaum clears it for FMU. Try from the Trojans that time gets right into the gloves of Casey. Danu played it down line to Pavoni. Free kick given to the Patriots. Rough play that time from Emily Hine and Joanna Kittbaum. Ball in from Adkins, off the heads of a couple of Patriots. Gives the Patriots a throw in now. Actually calling it a corner kick for FMU, as it looked like the Trojans tried to save it by kicking it more down the field for a throw-in. Ball in, off the head of Gott that time. Trojans come away with it. Since the Patriots had success on their first corner kick, this time the Trojans were ready. Ball from Casey. Santa Bria tries to keep it in play. Tackles from the Patriots. Can't get there. Ball in the box. Great tackle by Santa Bria to keep it away from number two, Copley. Santa Bria takes it off the chest. Makes a cut. Pulling back over by the Trojans. Ball forward this time to Espinosa. Espinosa with the ball in and a corner kick, the first corner kick for the Trojans today with just under 5.5 to go in the first half. Looks like this corner going to be taken by Melwin Gaffas, senior forward out of Saint-Germain-de-la-Grange, France. They play it short. And another corner kick this time for the Trojans. This time on the air, shot, and just right off the volley. But that time wide right from Gabby Marshall. Foul on Abby Brosnahan this time. Probably for the hand placement. Free kick is low. Shot. And Casey makes the dive for the save. Under 3.5 to go. Under 3 to go. Trojans lead 2-1. They might have another opportunity here with a throw in right in front of the Patriots' side. Here's Giuliano. Casey has to come up for it, and she does. Garon, nice move. Ball to Pavone. Defending. Throw in now for the Trojans with under 2 minutes to go. Ball played this time to Emily Hine. She's playing a ball in, and that one goes past the net with about 1:15 to go. The Patriots will have a goal kick, and we'll see if they have another opportunity on the Trojan side of the field.
One minute remaining.
Played to Hine. And they'll call foul on Hine this time. Free kick for the Patriots with under 30 seconds. Santa Bria is going to lay it there for Adkins to take.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
And that'll be it for the first half, where the University of Mount Olive Trojans are leading the Francis Marion University Patriots 2-1. Let's check out some of the halftime stats. Let's start off with the visiting Trojans so far. 2 goals, one for Delia Alwood, one for Malwin Goffes. 1 shot for Alwood and Goffes as well, both of them on goal, of course. 1 shot for the defender, Jocelyn Gott. 1 shot for Amanda McLeod. Both of those shot off target for the Trojans. 2 shots for the midfielder. Looks to be number 26, Riley Baker. 1 shot on goal for her. 1 shot for number 17, Gabby Marshall. One of those also being on goal for the goalkeeper for the Trojans. Nicole Solicito, 1 goal allowed, 1 save here through 1 half of action. Looking at the Patriots side, 1 shot from Jada Pearson, 2 shots from Abby Brosnan, 2 on goal with 1 finding the back of the net in the first minute and a half of this match. Looking at the substitutes, Kylie Reif with 1 shot as well for the Patriots. The goalkeeper, Emily Casey, 2 goals allowed, 3 saves in the first half. Patriots still down 2-1. We'll come right back to some second half action after we take a break here on the Patriots Sports Network.
If there's a prettier place to go to college in the springtime, we don't know about it. Of course, we think it's the place to be all year round. Francis Marion University. Unparalleled beauty, unbeatable affordability, education that will last a lifetime.
Conference Carolinas is where tradition is unmatched and excellence is earned daily in the classroom, during practice, and in high-level competition.
Tigerville has become Title Town.
Our virtues set us apart. We daily work to build champions in body, mind, and soul. It's who we are. This is Conference Carolinas.
Decked out in their regalia, and as you look up at all those people, you see families, huge families. And you know why all those people are there? Because this is the very first one, the very first graduate. So special.
If there's a prettier place to go to college in the springtime, we don't know about it. Of course, we think it's the place to be all year round. Francis Marion University. Unparalleled beauty, unbeatable affordability, education that will last a lifetime.
Conference Carolinas is where tradition is unmatched and excellence is earned daily in the classroom, during practice, and in high-level competition.
Tigerville has become Title Town.
Our virtues set us apart. We daily work to build champions in body, mind, and soul. It's who we are. This is Conference Carolinas.
Decked out in their regalia, and as you look up at all those people, you see families, huge families. And you know why all those people are there? Because this is the very first one, the very first graduate. So special.
If there's a prettier place to go to college in the springtime, we don't know about it. Of course, we think it's the place to be all year round. Francis Marion University. Unparalleled beauty, unbeatable affordability, education that will last a lifetime.
Conference Carolinas is where tradition is unmatched and excellence is earned daily in the classroom, during practice, and in high-level competition.
Hagerville has become Titletown.
Our virtues set us apart. We daily work to build champions in body, mind, and soul. It's who we are. This is Conference Carolinas.
Decked out in their regalia, and as you look up at all those people, you see families, huge families. And you know why all those people are there? Because this is the very first one, the very first graduate. So special.
If there's a prettier place to go to college in the springtime, we don't know about it. Of course, we think it's the place to be all year round. Francis Marion University. Unparalleled beauty, unbeatable affordability, education that will last a lifetime.
Conference Carolinas is where tradition is unmatched and excellence is earned daily in the classroom, during practice, and in high-level competition.
Hagerville has become Titletown.
Our virtues set us apart. We daily work to build champions in body, mind, and soul. It's who we are. This is Conference Carolinas.
Decked out in their regalia, And as you look up at all those people, you see families, huge families. And you know why all those people are there? Because this is the very first one, the very first graduate. So special.
If there's a prettier place to go to college in the springtime, we don't know about it. Of course, we think it's the place to be all year round. Francis Marion University. Unparalleled beauty, unbeatable affordability, education that will last a lifetime.
Right back here on the Patriot Sports Network. When we come back here to second half action, if you're just now tuning in, I'm Alex Wover bringing you this Wednesday evening women's soccer action here in Conference Carolinas. Here in Florence, South Carolina on Hartzler Field, the Trojans lead the Patriots 2-1 after taking the lead off a penalty kick there late in the first half. Patriots got on board within the first minute and a half with a header from Abby Brosnahan. We'll see if they come out with that same energy here in the second half. Give me a free kick now for the Trojans right in front of their side. Ball into the box over the head of number 17, Gabby Marshall. Jordan White going to be right there for the rebound on the pass that time from Olivia Womack. Throw in now for FMU. Played it to Sink, who's looking for Restrepo. And they'll call her offsides. Free kick for the Trojans. The Trojans held the majority of the possession in the first half, 51-49%. Played this time to Tiana Hill. Hill inside the box. Try to play it towards the middle. Adkins there with the stop. And a yellow card that time for, I believe, Tiana Hill. Throw in now for the Patriots, right in front of their bench. Restrepo looking for Jarvis off her knee. There's Reif. Plays Jarvis wide. Jarvis 1v1. Throw in now for FMU. As Aguirre ball in, headed out here at the top of the box. Jordan White. Played out of bounds. That time off the foot of Sarah Brechlin. Stepped in front of that time by Adkins. Almost a own goal, potentially, that time, but Santa Bria gets lucky as she misses the ball. It'll stay with FMU as it came off a Trojan's foot last. And that free kick opportunity sails out of bounds. Now the Trojans remain in possession. off the boot of Hein. Patriots get back possession. Just under 37 to go. And that's going to be off the foot of Ezaguirre for a Trojans corner kick. Ball played into the box. Off the head. There's a Trojan in front of the net. Gets a chance, but whips it and ends up a goal kick for Casey. Francis Marion University Athletics would like to thank the following sponsors: Adidas, Circle Park Behavioral Health Services, McLeod Regional Medical Center, Ken Jackson and Remax Professionals, Pepsi, McDonald's, Rains Hospitality, including Fairfield Inn, Spring Hill Suites, Courtyard by Marriott, Comfort Inn, and Hyatt Place, King Cadillac Buick GMC, Cloud Sports Medicine, Chick-fil-A, State Farm, and Agent Jim Stewart, Quincy's Steakhouse, Little Caesars, La Quinta Inn and Suites, KFC and Arby's, Florence Toyota, Waffle House, PD Electric Cooperative, Sparrow and Kennedy Tractor Supply, McCall Supply Incorporated, Western Sizzlin Steakhouse, State Credit Union, and Zaxby's. Give and go plays here by the Trojans. Ball into the box, off the head of a Trojan, and falls into the hands of Casey. Free kick now for the Trojans. Number 21, Ashley Lindsay, picking up the foul. Giving the Trojans an opportunity here close to midfield. And a goal from the Trojans this time. From the free kick, the Trojans jump ahead 3-1 here in the second half. As we will take a quick look at a replay here in just a moment. The Trojans now with a 3-1 lead with 33-11 to go. Let's check out the replay now. Shot. Followed into the back of the net. Definitely something that the Trojans needed here in the second half to get going. And they have a 2-goal lead now with 33-11 to go. And they try to play it quick towards sink, but a bad touch gives it back to the Trojans. Restrepo with it. Plays it out to Sink. Fantastic tackle that time by a Trojan, number 14, Scarlett Espinosa. She swept the ball right from Sink's feet. Gave her a tough fall that time. Be a free kick here for the Trojans. 31 to go. Shot this time into the gloves of Casey. No more free kick magic for the Trojans. Up 3-1 right now. Out wide to Jordan White. Sends the ball sailing down line, but just out of bounds. Substitution now for the Patriots. Courtney Deneau coming on for Jordan White. Pavone now coming back on for Lalondra Jarvis. Brenda Vargas running into a wall of Patriots that time. Adkins plays it forward. Reif with a chance. 1v1. She's going to have to outplace number 16, Samantha Hamrick. She gets around her. And the chance for Reif that time scooped up by Solicito. She was defended by basically three Trojans that time. Pavone with it. Plays Reif. Plays Pavone, takes a shot. And she's fouled that time by number 14, Scarlett Espinosa. Free kick going to be taken just outside the 20-yard box by Restrepo. Four-man wall. Restrepo's shot just right. Trying to bend it around that wall. Tough move for Restrepo that time. Thank you. Espinosa pressured by Pavone. Pavone gets it to Brosnahan and a throw in now for the Patriots on the Trojan side of the field. Ball played back to Solicito. Rife has to get back on side to be involved in the play. She is now. Danu with the pressure this time on Womack. Ball played into the box. Shot in upper left corner of the net. Trojans put one back in there to make it 4-1 here in the second half. Trojans, let's take a look at the replay this time. Shot from just about the top of the box off of the given pass. No Patriots in sight to pressure the shot. And Mount Olive now with a three-goal margin here with 25 left to go in the second half. Headed out by Adkins. Back towards Rife, she tries to spin out. Ball towards the left side, out wide. Split to the middle, deflected. Into the box for Casey. Split Garon and Restrepo that time. Trojans give and go. Ball to the middle. This is Hill. Shot. Just misses wide. Goal kick now here for the Patriots. Reif putting on pressure towards the entire Trojans back line. Casey has to come out. Offsides call on Kylie Reif. Deflected back to Sink. Going to head it towards Reif. This time, Tiana Hill was looking for number 7, Emily Hine. That time was actually looking for number 2, McKenna Copley. Tiana Hill on the pass. Don't think I've seen that one in a long time. Pavone with the fake pass back to her defense. Didn't quite get the Trojans this time. Two subs now coming on for the Patriots, Inara Ezeguirre and Lindsay Downey. Alejandra Mesa comes on as well. And Pavone goes down pretty hard that time. And Pavone able to get up this time. We'll continue play. We'll get a quick break from both sides with the humidity here in Florence, South Carolina. We'll take a quick break right here on the Patriot Sports Network and come right back.
Conference Carolinas is where tradition is unmatched and excellence is earned daily in the classroom, during practice, and in high-level competition.
Hagerville has become Titletown.
Our virtues set us apart. We daily work to build champions in body, mind, and soul. It's who we are. This is Conference Carolinas.
Decked out in their regalia, and as you look up at all those people, you see families, huge families. And you know why all those people are there? Because this is the very first one, the very first graduate. So special.
If there's a prettier place to...
Right back here on the Patriot Sports Network. Coming back into the break, the University of Mount Olive Trojans still lead 4-1 against Francis Marion University Patriots. Patriots down on the Trojan side of the field. Trojans sporting the black and green. Patriots sporting the all white with red stripes down the side. A good ball from Pavone, but a call this time from our officials is going to end the Patriots' chances at that opportunity and give them, give the Trojans a free kick. Pretty much a goal kick here. That ball played towards Reif. Alejandra Mesa with it. Out of bounds. Ball for the Patriots. Throw in now. And a corner kick for FMU now. Free kick going to be taken by Alejandra Mesa. That ball low, headed out to Pavone. Takes a touch and a shot. Pearson took too many touches in the box. And Alejandra Mesa, not sure if she was going for a shot or a pass to Brosnahan that time, but Solicito was taken out by Brosnahan. No call. Free kick, though, for the Trojans just outside the box. 15-45 here in the second half. Trojans still lead 4-1. Give and go, ball into the box, headed out by Adkins, shot. Somehow kept out by the top post and put in the back of the net by Tiana Hill. So there's the first time today we've seen the height factor in against Emily Casey, who comes in at 5 foot. Comes back in off the top post, does not cross the line, but then Tiana Hill finishes it up, which is the Trojans up to a 5-1 lead here in the second half with 14:40 to go on the clock. Pushes it to midfield now. They were looking for Kylie Reif. Off the shoulder of Pearson, gives the ball back to the Trojans. Throw in back to number 5, Jocelyn Gott. Pavone with the pressure. Be a free kick for the Trojans after some physical play between Espinosa and Pavone. Give and go. Trojans here trying to just possess the ball in this final 13. It's not impossible to get 4 goals in 13 minutes, but it definitely is a challenge. So we get a couple last-minute substitutions here for the Trojans. And it'll be a throw-in now for UMO. About 12 minutes to go. Patriots have to play with a bit of a sense of urgency now if they want to put any in the back of the net. The Patriots haven't had a legit opportunity since the first minute and a half of this match when they put in the first goal off of a header from Brosnahan. They've struggled to find their ways into the Trojans' box and set up really good plays for themselves. Trojans of Mount Olive coming in as a good conference squad. Francis Marion knew this was going to be a challenge, and that's what they did. They came out strong quickly, but the Trojans matched that energy very fast. And now they lead by 4 goals here with 11:05 to go. Pearson gets called on here by Thomas Rutherford, our official in the midfield. Ball into the box. Shot and scooped up by Casey after it's deflected off a few Patriots. Substitution for the Trojans. Taking number 5, Jocelyn Gott off the field. Trojans working the Patriots side of the field. Under 10 minutes to go. Defended well that time. Trojans give the Patriots a throw-in opportunity. And Alejandro Mesa comes up with it, plays Pavone. Free kick now for the Trojans. Ball over the top of the defense. Shot blocked by Casey. Casey with really good positioning that time. Had to come off of her line. Take a quick replay at this as a good through ball that time by the Trojans, but Casey just takes the entire width of the goal away that time. Makes herself look big. Makes it hard to shoot around her. As the sun is starting to creep below the forest line here at Hartzler Field. That corner kick ball goes over everybody's head. Once the sun goes down here in Florence, we can finally be at peace up here in the press box. Good chance that time by the Trojans, headed over the top of the net. Goal kick here for Casey with 6:50 to go. Pavone forward to Mesa. off of Mesa. That's going to be a throw-in for the Trojans. Restrepo going to try it herself. No call that time for Restrepo as she is taken down by a Trojan, but play is continued. Inside the box, ball towards a Trojan. Coming in. Patriots trying to escape and knock it out of the box, and they do that time, giving the Trojans a throw-in towards their side. Last 5.5 to go here. Ball in the box, headed out by Santa Bria. Shot just right behind the goal. Casey will get a goal kick here with just under 5 minutes to go. Ball played towards Reef. Shot that time, low skitter. That's going to be into the hands of Casey. Good job by Danu that time to get her foot in front of it. They're going to get it to Restrepo, who had a chance last time but got a no call. She'll play Mesa at about midfield. Mesa's going to play Pavone, but outpaced that time. Throw in now for the Trojans, under 3.5 to go. Mesa plays Restrepo, who takes a shot. And that one had plenty of room over the top of the net. Although in this situation, you pretty much fire from all cylinders as you're down 5-1 with 3 minutes to go now. Now free kick here for FMU. Just outside the midfield circle. .215 to go with Danu taking the free kick. Danu, the lone Patriot in the back line, under 2 minutes to go, was able to stop that play from occurring. It could have been a 1v1 that time for the Trojans, but good awareness by the wing back for the Patriots, Courtney Danu. Pavone, surrounded by two Trojans, Now she has a couple of Patriots in her vicinity. Free kick now for FMU with a minute 15 to go. And Gracie Adkins is going to take it for the Patriots with a minute remaining. Adkins, chip pass towards Reef. Got a shot on goal. Good stuff that time by Solicito to be in position. Maybe a little bit more power on it from Reif, and that might have found its way into the back of the net, but Solicito in the right spot that time. Under 30 to go. We can go ahead and write this up as a Trojans win, but see what the Patriots can do with about 12 to go. Reif had an opportunity that time, but the Trojans win the battle.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
And that'll do it here for the first game of the doubleheader. The Patriots fall to the Trojans of Mount Olive 5-1. We'll stay right here with you and talk over a little bit of some final results stats for you. Let's take a look at the Trojan side first for Mount Olive. One goal for Deliah Allwood, one goal for Malin Goffis. That one from Goffis came off the penalty kick that Allwood eventually drew up in the box. And then two goals by number 31, Tiana Hill. Three shots, three on goal, two goals. Looking at the subs for the Trojans, two shots for Alex Baker, the midfielder, one on goal. Four shots for Riley Baker, who led the team, with two of those on goal and one assist. The Patriots on their side this time, we'll take a look at some of their individual stats. The leading shot taker. A three-way tie between Valentina Restrepo, Abby Brosnahan, and Kylie Reif. Two shots apiece. One on goal for Reif. Two on goal for Brosnahan, including the one goal in the first minute and a half for the Patriots. One assist for Courtney Deneau. And looking at the goalkeepers for both sides, Mount Olive, Nicole Solicito with one goal allowed, two saves on the match. And Emily Casey in her freshman debut, replacing the injured Michaela Willits. Five goals allowed, seven saves, though. That'll do it here for the first game of the doubleheader, though. Final score, 5-1. We'll see Trojans and Patriots here again at 7 o'clock as the men's soccer program takes the field. I'm Alex Wober. I'll see you here in a few minutes right here on the Patriots Sports Network.